Their sighting, Betty Hill began having dreams in which she and Barney were taken aboard a flying saucer and medically examined. The Hills filed a sighting report with NICAP, a newly formed UFO research group. Then, the emotional trauma from their experience prompted Barney and Betty Hill to seek the psychiatric help of Dr. Benjamin Simon, a prominent Boston psychiatrist. Dr. Simon placed the hills under hypnosis during a series of visits. In these sessions, the memories of the hills' missing 2 hours were supposedly unlocked. On later listening to tape recordings of their accounts, their conscious memories were restored.
you to fuck your fist. It's a brand new dance and it goes like this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6!
To illustrate his story.
It's very big, and it's not that far, and I can see it tilted toward me.
Tilted? And what does it look like now when you say tilted? Did you see
it
wings?
Looks like a big, big pancake with windows and rows of windows, and I look up and down the road. Can't somebody come and tell me this is not there? It can't be. There's a man. Is he a captain? What is he? It's gonna look at me.
I'm ready.
You must be.
message for the new year.
I don't think I'll hold you close, I'll just hold you responsible for another loudmouth advertisement. To crack your cardboard cone. I don't think I'll hold you close, I'll just hold you responsible for another loud-mouth advertisement.
Which it is.
Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Regression, Betty Hill described the deeply disturbing events that she believed took place inside the landed spacecraft.
So then they rolled me over on my back, and the examiner has a long needle in his hand, and I see the needle, and it's bigger than any needle I've ever seen. And I asked him what he's going to do with it. And he said, just a simple test of alternating. And I asked him what. And he said he just wants to put it in my navel. And it's just a simple test. And I tell him, no, it won't hurt. Don't do it. Don't do it. And he said, no, it won't hurt. And he takes a navel into my navel. And I'm crying, and I tell him it's hurting, it's hurting, it's hurting, take it out. And then the leader, he goes over and he puts his hand, runs his hand in front of my eyes, and he says, I'll be all right, I won't feel it. And all the pain goes away.
a new song called Friendly Fire.
Wonder why.
5 years later, the bizarre experience of Betty and Barney Hill became legendary as a cover story in Look magazine, and later in a book called The Interrupted Journey. Both claimed to describe the first reported alien abduction in the United States. While their psychiatrist, Dr. Simon, remained skeptical of the stories the Hills related under hypnosis, the publicity opened a floodgate of reports of UFO encounters that authors like Dr. David M. Jacobs call abduction.
Thank you. 1994. We played for Bicap at Rush Weekend, and we played for free. Didn't get a damn dime, we raffled off a shirt, got fucked up. It was a pretty good show all together, so whoever's watching this, enjoy it.
Better.
Give me E, Mike.
Every song, pick up a piece of clothing. Check on the floor. Men and women, come on. These next two songs are about the relationship between humans and animals. It's a fucked up relationship. Animals are not biological machines for humans to consume. Mass murder.
have a ghost dance for him. Because he might be a little on a commune in the Northwest or something. Flower power kind of bongo full boom. This first song's called Bonky Number 3. It's on a comp. It's going to be on Reservoir Records. And it's about being unemployed, which I am.
Life, there are people cut. We're all full of ourselves. Total fucking shit.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah! Let's burn! Synthetically defined, spiritually denied. We must shake off that shell. 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 It lies in the hands. It lies in the hands. It lies in the hands. It lies in the hands.
This track is called My Walk. The warm-up instrumental, Jonah, sounds okay. We'll be right back.
Fucking America.